But instead of just simply sticking to whatever I wrote, which I put a lot of time into it, I would like to speak heart to heart directly with you, because very simply put, leaving your home or office and coming here today is showing that information security or cyber security is an important component to you individually or to your organization. Now, that importance is not by buying more hardware or more software or just simply training. The first part is understanding what is the impact of IT security or cybersecurity to my business. So, when I looked at the list of the people who registered for this event, I saw people from central government, from municipalities, from universities, from judicial, from industries, from banks, from almost every sector in the country. Now, this rich mix of experiences on the tables today is outstanding. It's not only important for us to be together, to network and talk, by making the initial statement, I am definitely not the most experienced. Some of the people on the tables over here have a lot longer and much more intense experience than others. We would like to talk to each other because this event is about networking. It's not about listening to speakers only. It's about talking to each other. It's very important to understand what are our mutual concerns and how can we bring that cumulative knowledge to our service. And how do we understand how other people address the challenges that we face time after time? Now, I have a few important questions to ask. I'm not lecturing because I'm not the most experienced. That is already established. I only have a few questions that came to my mind. I could not find 100% discrete answers to them. What I hope to do is during today and tomorrow, together, we will find discrete, clear answers to these questions. One of the questions is, where does IT security fall in our agenda today? Is IT security a supporting function, the way it used to be? Or is it a core function and business enablement to our services? Who is delivering today a service without touching any form of IT? Anybody? This is the point. None. Every one of us is using one form or another of an IT component in our service to deliver the intended value. Now, so IT is not a supporting function. It is a business enablement component. It is a pillar in what we do. The second question, is IT as it is handled today by IT departments, it's handling the information technology component. Now, let's take the information component out. Is it just the information technology or is it the information itself that really matters to the organization? How much is the information impact on us today? How many of us can do without information? How much can we deliver the services that we deliver without information, without accurate, solid, credible, integrity pieces of information? And how do we reach it? In what forms? That's very important. Because today, I don't think mobility is an option anymore. People want to function on the move. Everyone wants to be able to do whatever he's supposed to do without having to be stuck to a specific terminal or a specific office or a specific location. How do you secure this mobility? How do you maintain the flow of data from the back-end system, whether it is cloud-based or data center-based? The flow of information from the data center, from the database, to the application server, to to the end machine, whatever it is, whether it is my smartphone, whether it is my home PC, or whether it is my tablet, whatever form of access to information I decide to use. Is the flow of information secure? Is the repository where my information is falling in secure? Important questions that we need to put on our discussions today and tomorrow. Now, luckily, I was a part of YesSir during the past 5 years. I was honored to be a part of that journey. The transformation journey is not only in the government. The government is transforming by royal decree. It has to transform, it's not an option. But so is everybody else. Actually, the banking industry in Saudi Arabia is amazingly mature when it comes to services. The utility functions are almost as mature and very much approaching. Some government organizations are approaching the banking sector maturity in services and e-services. This journey is telling us one thing. When you move from specific offices, specific business hours, specific people that you know and deal with, when you go into e-service, when your service is being served without business hours, without specific locations, and without knowing people, this is a different ball game. You are not associated with hours or locations anymore. People will not give you an excuse for your service being down at 3 o'clock in the morning, or on a weekend, or even during holidays. Your service has to be 5 nines compliant, not only 3 nines as it used to be in the past. People are demanding, our service community, they are demanding 5 nines. Why is the service down? Should it be? With the level of maturity today in IT and infrastructures and connectivity, your service should never be down. And there are always ways on how to reduce or eliminate downtime. So that brings us to an important topic, business continuity. But the question I would like to put on your table today, is business continuity the availability of my service only? Is it the technology component only? Or is it also the people, the location, the process, the regulations I operate under, the value delivery channels that I have? It is a lot of things. It is not just the technology part, where most of us are probably aware and acting on the technology component of our business continuity, but not on all the components. Imagine a person who has knowledge and information that is not documented properly, that is tacit knowledge, that is not searchable, or indexable, or accessible, or even usable by other people in the organization. And this guy just disappears. Whether he resigns, or he falls sick, or dies. What happens? How much loss does this organization have? Do we have measures on how to measure the tacit knowledge in our organizations? This is a basic component, basic questions that we need to ask ourselves. It's not just how much technology do we put in. How much do we use and utilize that technology to assure that all the knowledge associated with our value chain is properly accessible by everybody who needs it within the organization and our customers? One of the questions I would like to put on the table is information availability or information access the responsibility of IT departments only? Now, the impact to information does not stop at IT. Today, when your service is down, the first person who is hit is the head of the organization, because the media will not have mercy on that guy. They will hit him, they will hit him hard. So, at what level should the organization address the information access and the business continuity? Is it at the board level? Is it the CIO level? Is it the CISO level? Is it the IT director level? At what level
should information availability and protection be addressed in the organization? Important questions. Information governance. Is it in the DNA of the organization, or is it just something that we put in paper and we shelf it somewhere? Maybe you have more questions to ask that I have. If I manage to trigger your thought, then I think I made it. Then I deserve the honor of opening this event. Think with me, what are the important and critical factors that impact our information access? Because it's the information age. The way we have value chains and we have supply chains, today we have information chain. Let's consider the impact of the information chain on our business. Thank you.
The next speaker, Mr. Tariq Chaudhary, the head of security and in the British Telecom, advisor in the Middle East, responsible for global services. Tariq is responsible for building critical links and relationships between business division and goals of the technical teams. He exercises at identifying program solutions and research challenges and security challenges facing organizations, and delivering on the vision to realize rapid improvement in the security posture.